I've got Dan and Joe here, and you guys are from WETA. Now, WETA is a phenomenal organization, and Sir Richard Taylor founded the organization. You guys have won numerous Academy Awards. You're well known for Lord of the Rings and all these special effects. We've interviewed Sir Richard Taylor. Mm-hmm. He's a great guy. Mm-hmm. You guys are based in New Zealand, mm-hmm. and in this film, you've basically taken all the actors, a lot of them, because some U.S. soldiers don't need motion capture suits. Mm-hmm. You put them in motion capture suits, and you create the ape around them. And you make them so lifelike, not only to ape features, but a lot of them kind of reflect the actors that they are playing them. It's amazing.
Mm-hmm. That's what we've been working on for ever since we started working with Andy Serkis doing Gollum back in the days of Lord of the Rings. It's how do you capture human emotion and express it on a unique character? Because being able to create these fantastic characters like these apes gives you entree to a whole new world. Like now we're looking at a very human story, but through the mirror of seeing these apes that are very much like us. And hopefully it gives you pause and makes you think about what you're seeing.
How do you make it so lifelike?
It's a lot of attention to detail. I mean, we really study the animals, first of all, and we also study the actors. And one of the key things you touched on, which is we try to do everything we can to take those actors, their expressions, and make sure that our digital characters can make the same expressions. And that can be a real challenge because chimpanzees have very different anatomy than humans. So they've got bigger muzzles, and some of the rest of the shapes of their face isn't quite the same. So we have to do certain things to adjust the face in order to make the performance really come through.
Now you talk computers. How ridiculous are the computers you guys use? Are we talking, I mean, they gotta be maxed out. So 128 gigs of RAM, 18 core Xeon processors. What are we using?
And lots of them.
Yeah. Lots of them.
Yeah.
I mean, are these things just beasts?
Yes. Yeah, it's a big room full of computers. Yeah.
Render farms, I imagine you have your.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
And how many artists will work on a project like this?
I think we had about
800 on this one.
Did we hit 800?
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Some of them only worked a couple weeks, and some of them worked a couple years.
Yeah, but probably the core was about 450 that stayed with it the whole time.
Yeah. That's remarkable.
Yeah.
You guys do such a great job. How'd you get with the company?
Oh, I went down to work on Gollum for Two Towers and never left.
Yeah.
And do you think that this is the best project you've worked on so far?
It's certainly, I think, our best work to date. I mean, it's really nice having the chance to work on three films like this and seeing all the characters come together and really, you know, have everything firing the way it should.
And to work with filmmakers who are so talented and actors that are so talented, you know, it's a treat that you don't always get. So it's pretty amazing when these projects come along.
Were there any new techniques you guys deployed in this film?
So many.
Yes, a lot, exactly.
Give me a taste, a little.
Well, I mean, a lot of it really came down to the way we do the lighting and the detail for, you know, for the eyes and for the fur, because it really helps bring a realism to it that we couldn't do even on Dawn.
I gotta tell you, it is so good in this film. I thought the whole film, is this real? Is this a costume? I really was going back and forth. I could not figure it out until the end. And I kind of knew, but I was like, it's too real. It's too good. You guys did a great job. Thank you so much.